What is up, my Planet Coaster friends? Johnny Five Alive here, and we are back with another episode of Let's Build. And in today's episode, we're going to be doing something different. We're going to be building a sci-fi Missy Goods shop for the sci-fi universe that I've been working on. So stay tuned, and let's check it out. So today I just wanted to do something different, guys, because I needed a little bit of a break from Yetiland, and sometimes it's good to switch up your creativity in order to, you know, just kind of get a refresher. I find that if I've been working on something too long and I, you know, it can sometimes get tedious or overwhelming. And I was sort of getting there with Yetiland. And not to worry though, I have a Yetiland episode ready for you guys, and it's probably the most epic one yet. So going back to what I was saying, it's sometimes you get these creative blocks and it can get, you know, You can find yourself feeling a little bit overwhelmed. And sometimes I find that if you just switch it up and go build something else or do something creative or try to just kind of get some creative juices flowing on something entirely new, you can oftentimes go back to another project and find yourself refreshed. And that's exactly what happened here. So today we're building a Missy Goods shop, and I didn't quite do it as quickly as I wanted to. So we have some patrons and Discord members that are in Discord that have been featured on the show and whatnot. And they were just kind of hanging out in voice chat with me. And we started up a screen share call. And they kind of were building their stuff while watching me build my stuff. So we were hanging out, and I was showing them things in here and then like asking them questions. So they had actually some creative input on what was happening here. So I ended up spending most of Saturday doing this, but this is 10 times speed. You guys will get to see the whole thing in like 40 minutes, which, like I said, it is probably longer because I think it took us like 8 hours to build this thing, and I usually crank these things out in just a few hours. But I was asking them about this and that, and I think the overall creative design turned out a lot better because some of their input. I was asking them questions, and I think if they weren't around, the design would have turned out slightly different. So I am happy with the overall results. Back to what I was saying about like creative blocks and stuff, I felt, you know, you guys have been seeing me working on the sci-fi universe, and that was like my original goal. And I think one of our YouTube subscribers said, hey, I think maybe it's time you start working on a park. And it is true, because I hadn't done a park in some time since the Good Golly Miss Molly scenario. And I was just sitting there cranking out all of these different buildings and working on this universe. And the overall idea was I was making all these buildings so that I could build a sci-fi park. I decided to go back to my roots, go back to creating, like when they did the winter update, I was really excited to create all these new shops, the Missy Goods shops, the Pip shops, and all those different things. And I think one of my last buildings that I did for this universe was that one right over there that you can see, Planet Gulpy. And that one performed really well. And this I decided to take the same kind of design. It's going to be like, it's going to look kind of like a Tim Hortons, and but I'm also going to kind of brand it to Planet Gulpy. And Planet Gulpy was kind of inspired by a 7-Eleven, so they're very similar in those styles, like their building shapes. However, I always end up putting my own creative spin on it and doing like a lot of like creative touches and putting character on it. Like the Planet Gulpy has donuts on it, it has a coffee cup, it has Slurpees and stuff like that. So this one is going to just be donuts and coffee. So it's kind of like a 2-for-1 brand, a Missy Goods / Street Fox coffee shop. And I'm really happy with the overall design. And somebody messaged me and was like, I finished it on Saturday and uploaded it Saturday night. It might have even been Sunday at that point. And that Sunday it was already in the most popular downloads of the week on Steam, which completely surprised me because it usually takes a while. So it's already performing really well, and I'm pretty excited to show you guys the final result. So once we get through all the footage, at the very end there will be a little bit of a presentation where I spin the camera around at normal speed. You get to see it. Links will be down in the description to download it. You can also find it on my workshop. It's been up there for a day or two now. So, or you can find it on the front page of Steam. So yeah, I just want to like put some signs. Now, the one disappointing thing about the winter update, when they give us, we were talking about this in Discord, we had a huge conversation about it, and you know, they gave us all these new shops and stuff, but they didn't give us any customization for those shops. They didn't give us any signs, they didn't give us any menus. They're like, I think Missy Goods got two donuts and they were not the greatest in art terms, and that was it. So I have to make my own Missy Goods signs. They didn't give us any mascots or any memorabilia. There's really nothing to go with it, so you have to be creative and come up with the stuff. And I thought that was a little bit disappointing, to be honest, because what's the point in having these new branding lines if you're not going to fully do it? I'd say I would have rather waited for all these shops with more choices, and I don't know if they're just going to skip over it and not add any of those new choices in the future, but I really hope they do. And what was really funny, you might see it at some point in this video, they ended up messing up a bunch of the old signs, and they're like, it's actually like bugs now. And see, these are the two donuts you get, those are the only ones, and I was like, my donuts, I'm gonna make my own donuts. So I did make donuts for Planet Gulpy, but they weren't the same style donuts as Missy Goods. So the Missy Goods donuts that you get, or that they sell, are pink with white sprinkles and brown with white sprinkles. So my donuts were, I did the vanilla dip and I did the chocolate, double chocolate donuts. So I decided I would recreate the donuts and make them match the Missy Goods donuts, and that would help the branding. What was I talking about just a second ago? Oh yeah. So I was saying how they reused some of the stuff, or they didn't really add much memorabilia. Well, the Chief of Beef, they basically copy pasted it and turned it into a hot dog squad. Not the hot dog squad. The pizza pen. And we are looking at the logo. If you zoom in close enough, the pizza pen is right over top of the Chief of Beef. It says the Chief of Beef is cut off. Like, it's literally copy pasted. Yeah, it's like Chief of Beef Pizza Pen. I don't know if that was intentional. It doesn't look like it's intentional because it's half cut off. But you can literally see that they took their Pizza Pen logo and slapped it over top of the Chief of Beef. And it's just a little disappointing because I would love... I don't know if you guys saw my sad pizza review thing, but like the slice of pizza, it's supposed to be a bandit, but it's upside down, and it has this two like peppers for eyes, and it looks like a sad pizza. And, you know, it would have been nice to have like a pizza pan bandit memorabilia line where you have like a mascot, or you have some big slices of pizza, nice pretty signs. I don't really like the fact that they used the logo of the Chief of Beef and just copy pasted it. Here you can see off to the side here, there's a failed Missy Goods. I tried making her kind of small and seeing what pieces I could use, and it failed. So I ended up cutting that out of the footage to trim it down by like 10-15 minutes, because I sat there and I was trying to build this thing, and I spent a lot of time, wasted time on it, because it just turned out like crap. So I decided to go with some bigger basic shapes so that I could get some more detail. Using those small cylinders, I could get the skinny legs, and that sort of thing. So I don't know if you guys know what the Missy Goods looks like, because there are no signs for it, but if you put down a Missy Goods shop and you zoom in really closely, you will see a little girl with a bag of goods and a donut in her hand, and she's kind of all black and white. So we're trying to recreate that, and she's got these crazy pigtails and stuff like that. So I wanted to try and recreate that, because I like to do, like, that's my style, is I add character to my buildings. So whether it's like a big Slurpee or big hot dogs, or, you know, big burgers, or a cosmic cow recreation, you guys see in my buildings, I always try to do some sort of characteristics. I'm like the Pixar guy, I guess. I like to animate my buildings and my creations as much as possible. I thought it was really important to have a Missy Goods character, because that'll really, like, you know, from a distance you'll see her and you'll just go, oh, that's Missy Goods. The donuts and the coffee that I put on the building wasn't quite enough for me. I really wanted to add something extra to it. So recreating her was worth it, and it paid off in the end, and I really like the way she turned out. Just trying to get her smile right here. And she's got a little funky smile. That's it right there. And it's kind of close to her eyes. It's really cute. And she's got a bag of goodies. And half the bag of has like a white shade to it. So I'm using some smaller spheres to try to get that detail in. And just kind of add that shading to the bag. Then put a couple cones in to show the top of the bag flaring out. A couple smaller cones to add some shading to it. And that's pretty much what it looks like. So yeah, I'm quickly looking at it there. If you were able to pause it, you'd see it. But now we're trying to fit a donut in her hand. But the problem is, all the donuts I made were way too big. And then I thought about using the one that came with the game. But it wasn't working. And the donut she's holding is technically black and white that goes with the logo. So I thought it would be appropriate if I made a smaller donut, but the problem is these donuts are like as small as I could possibly get them. And so first I'm trying out the black and white donut. So I colored it black and white, but it's still just so massive. It doesn't fit the logo, and it didn't like it. So I decided to go with the smallest, what do you call it, torus or whatever that shape is possible, the donut shape. And I didn't have anything I could use for sprinkles, so I was looking through, and we were just testing all the different icings and seeing what could work. And some people were suggesting rocks. There's like nothing small, and I'm trying to wedge in like little bits and see if I could get something to poke through. And eventually I settled with one of these icing bits and just slightly like poked it through the top. They're not like perfect sprinkles, but they worked, and I added enough of them to make it work. A little bit of a tedious task here, but the end result, it looks much better with the smaller donut, and even the donuts that are in the logo only have very few sprinkles. So I really just needed the shape. I feel like a couple black sprinkles would really help sell the fact that it's a donut. So that's pretty much it there. We stuff it in our hand and we have our Missy Goods. So she turned out pretty good, and we just slap her on top of the building in a second here. And there we go. So back to what I was talking about earlier about the customization with the shops being somewhat disappointing. I do wish they go in the future updates and add more stuff to the pizza pan and add more stuff to the Missy Goods and all that stuff, because you have all these really cool signs for the Cosmic Cow milkshakes, and you have big milkshakes, you have lots of signs, neon signs, you know, plain signs, all different sizes and shapes, ones that hang off the sides of walls, and then you have like the milkshakes and the milkshake signs. You really get a lot with it, and it makes you kind of have a lot to decorate when you're building a Cosmic Cow shop. And the same could be said with Chief of Beef. There's big giant burger guy signs, and you know, this Missy Goods right here is a great example of something that they could build, and it could even be a really good mascot, I think. So I really hope that they remember to go back and pay tribute to their shops. And I also saved Missy Goods off as a blueprint here, guys, so you can download her and build your own shops. So I also have a Cosmic Cow. If you haven't seen that, go check that out. So I'll probably do some more stuff like this in the future. And while I was building this, I was getting some ideas for Pip Shop. So I think what would be cool for Pip Shop is like some fruit bowls and some juice boxes. And instead of having these gardens that I build out front, I'll make water fountains. So just like big giant pools of water and different fountains and stuff, and make it like a water park kind of thing, because Pip Shop is all about juice, fruit smoothies, and water. So I think that would be also a really good shop for me to do in this style, and it make it like a big kind of Quickie Mart style Pip Shop. So I was thinking about that while I was building all this, and I think it might be a good addition to this little mini sci-fi series of shops I got going on. The Missy Goods turned out to match the Planet Gulpy really well, and these are my large style shops. I will probably do a small and medium version of Missy Goods. We'll see. It wouldn't be too hard, and I think it'd be fun, and I've been doing that for all my other shops, so I might as well. And there's a ton of shops that I have so far, over 40, that are all matching and cohesive like this. And I plan to continue to go on that route until we have three of every style shop. So a large, medium, and small. Some have humongous, and some have more or less. And generally, there's a size and shape for everybody in every area of your park. And there's a lot of variety, and I like that. So I'm basically setting, I'm building what you call a pack, a sci-fi pack. So you're going to be able to, you know, if you need a big one, you can, there's like a big one. If there's a small one, if you're, you know, you're building a tight packed little area and you need a small little coffee shop, I got one for you. If you need a small little burger shop, I got one for you. So if you're making big areas, I have the big shops as well. And I'm also doing different styles. There's industrial, commercial, and research and development. And they're all sci-fi decorated. So it's, but some of them work in modern senses too. You could probably get away with that. But this pack is eventually going to be finished, and it's going to be ongoing as they add in new shops and rides, because I still want to do ride skins and stuff. So here you've seen in Planet Gulpy that I did planets out of the trees and stuff. I used colors and planets and made it like a little solar planet area, a little solar system. And this time I decided to use cookies. So we're just playing around with different cookies and trying to figure out how I can make these trees kind of look like yummy, because it's Missy Goods and she sells cookies and donuts and stuff. So we're just playing around with it and finding something that works. And I think I ended up finding something that works. So back to the sci-fi universe talk. I'm going to have, you know, different... By the time we're done, we're going to have like three of every shop. And there's still things from the old series that I need to go back. I feel like we could use a couple more Gulpy shops. They've added in a Gulpy soda. So I might go back and do a few things for Gulpy. And now we have things like Pizza Pen. So I'd love to make some kind of pizza parlor. That would be really fun. And, you know, I was excited when I saw these new shops, even though there weren't that many... there weren't that many options in terms of customization. On the flip side, though, if you're creative enough, you can build a lot of this stuff. It's just it just sucks in terms of signage. I want to have, just like the Chief of Beef, there are these big neon signs. You can't really recreate those with the editable text signs. And the editable text signs are, they're all one resolution scaled up. So the bigger the sign, the uglier it looks. And they bleed a little bit. And they're not, they don't quite have the nicest alpha channels, so they tend to look kind of ugly if they're really big and the letters are very limited. The Missy Good one turned out really nice. I'm happy with the way it looks, but again, it could be better if it was a Planet Coaster official sign. So I think we'll hopefully be able to come up with something nice for the Pizza Pen, but I'm going to be holding off on the rest of the sci-fi buildings until the new update that comes in March. And I was just looking at the lighting on my other buildings there to see what I could do for the lighting on Missy Goods. So here we have this big sign that I put for Planet Gulpy, and I want to recreate it for Missy Goods, because they are kind of like cousin buildings. They have similarities. So back to what I was saying is, I'm going to wait to finish the rest of the sci-fi universe buildings in the March update to see if they add any extra signage, if they add any extra shops, and that sort of thing. Because when I finished Planet Gulpy, not even like a week after, they're like, we released Gulpy Soda and Missy Goods Donuts. And I had donuts and coffee in Planet Gulpy, because I was thinking more like 7-Eleven, like you can get donuts at a 7-Eleven, you can get coffee, and you can get lots of like Slurpees and juice. But the focal point was the Slurpees and juice. So that's why it's Planet Gulpy. And that's the whole theme of it. The donuts and coffee was really a sidekick. But at the time, you couldn't actually get donuts. I just put donuts on it. So, and then I was like, oh crap, I could have put a donut shop in there and I could have done this. So, you know, or I would have saved the donuts to make a Missy Goods shop like I am now. So Planet Gulpy could have been a little bit better had I waited. So I want to wait a little bit longer and see what they do for this big update. I'm hoping they add more shops, shops customization. Because honestly, guys, that's one of my favorite areas in this game. I love the coasters. I love the rides. I love, you know, I'd have to say like every time they release a new flat ride, I'm not blown away, because it's not often that you build a huge park and fill it up with flat rides. I mean, I think I've placed, I don't know, a dozen flat rides. Like, I haven't even really ridden them all or look at them all. So, I'm not, like, too crazy about them creating new flat rides. A lot of people are like, I want more flat rides, I want more flat rides, and they're demanding it. But I feel like there's plenty of flat rides. And the game, to me, is more about, like, building a theme, building an area, building, like, a landscape, and building some coasters into it. The flat rides are just, like, they're just there to please the guests, I suppose. But it is really cool seeing what people could do with these ride skins. And that's a really neat aspect to it. But for me, I can't even keep up to do a ride skin for the current rides. So I'm happy with the amount of rides there are, and I'm pretty happy with the amount of shops there are as well. I just want to see more shop customization. Like, I would even love it if they went back and added in some more hot dog squad stuff, and, you know, added in a few extra things here and there. So I'm excited to see what's in this March update. We will have to see. But my biggest thing is I want to see go-karts. That's like my biggest requested thing. And then everything else, I just want more assets. I want more props. I just want more things to decorate with and to build with. Because then you could take those and combine them with what we have currently and come up with all sorts of new ideas. So the only two things I care about right now is and custom sorting. Custom sorting would be amazing. Some sort of improvement to the sorting system to make building easier and more efficient. And that's pretty much all that I'm hoping for, is more props and scenery decorations, building decorations, and go-karts. But from the looks of that screenshot when I did that update video, it looks like we're getting a new flat ride, that little pill spinny thing, and it looked like there was a new coaster in that screenshot. And yeah, so we'll have to see. I'm sure they're gonna be doing like a wide variety, and for whatever reason, I kind of hope they make more default blueprints, because the game should come with, I talked about this in like my very beta review and my very beginning review. The game doesn't come with enough default blueprints. Like, if you don't want to scour the workshop, I feel like if you just open the game out of the box, you should be able to start going, oh, I'm going to put some sci-fi buildings down, or I'm going to make some Western buildings. I kind of want to see them do what I'm doing here, create a series, a package. So I really hope that they kind of be creative themselves and make some extra default blueprints for the game. Because some of the times I like looking at it, and I like seeing what they did and getting ideas from, you know, Planet Coaster themselves. You know, a lot of my sci-fi buildings here, just having these AC units on the top, these ideas came from Planet Coaster's buildings. I just put my own spin on it. So, you know, some of the designs that they created influenced what I did. So, you know, I feel like if they're the leaders of the game, it's their game, they should be creating more blueprints themselves to help influence and inspire us to create. And also for those who just, you know, are playing in offline mode or whatever, and they just installed the game and they don't, you know, and they just want to build stuff, they should have a lot of options. So that's something I feel like they're going to try and touch on everything. They're going to touch on new coasters. They're going to touch on new rides and, you know, all that stuff. So, but for me, I really just want to see more customization and better tools, some improved custom sorting. And so we can filter these things and have our own set saved out. Because all the pieces I used, I'd love it if I could just do a Johnny filter and I just open that up and build or my sci-fi universe pack. So that's what I'm hoping for the most, and it'll get me super pumped up to do more let's builds. I'm already pumped up again just doing this little Missy Goods here. It really was refreshing just going back to my old ways of build this and, you know, start with something, layer it up. Like, we're getting through the final layering right now. We're adding details to our building, but this building here, it started from a very basic shape. It was basically like a giant rectangle, a tall rectangle, with smaller rectangles on the sides, and just for some undulation and nice different shapes. Then we put like an overhang on it, we put some ledges on it, we put some windows on it, we put some pillars and stuff, and it's basically just a pretty box. And then once you start putting like Missy Goods on there, some donuts, some coffees, some stripes, I made all this white and red stripes out of basic shapes, you know, that's really taking elevating the design, and then we put like touches of sci-fi on last. So we're doing like the AC units, the pipes, and we're gonna put some juice, or you call it icing filters. Like Planet Gulpy has these Slurpee making machines on the top of the building. This one's gonna have like icing for donut fats on the top of the building. So it's gonna have all their vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry flavors in vats. Basically doing the sci-fi touches right now. But before we get to doing the sci-fi, you could consider this a very modern building. If I just ripped off all the sci-fi, you could easily just fit it in as a Planet Coaster modern building. But I'm trying to switch it up and do things differently, because in the future, I don't know if you guys realize that there is another theme in this game called Planet Coaster as a theme. And it's actually my favorite theme. They have these like blue trims with like wooden brown backing panels, and it looks really nice. And it's great for like the center of your park, going through right down the mid lane. And you have all these modern shops. That's what I wanted to start, but it's pretty generic, and you can't, in terms of creativity, you can't do all these crazy things that I did with the sci-fi pieces, like giant robotic T-Rexes and stuff like that. You know, there's a lot of things that I have done that you probably could get away with the modern theme, but in some cases it might start crossing over and feeling a bit too sci-fi. But the whole theme behind it is very clean and wood and blue and just kind of plain. And I do want to touch on that in the future. And I think it would be a fun series to do a whole pack of modern Planet Coaster buildings. So right here, I'm adding the different flavors of icing in to the vats on the top. Yeah, I think that would be fun, but we'll probably get to the Planet Coaster stuff. The sci-fi universe is going to be ongoing, and every time they release new shops, I'm going to be going back and building more to my universe. So it probably will never end as long as Planet Coaster keeps getting updates. So it's kind of like my my trademark and my go-to. It's going to be my biggest pack ever. In terms of if we go to a Western set next or a fantasy set next, I will be doing cute, cozy things, but not like in large, medium, and small. I'll probably make like a really cozy burger shop for fantasy, and that'll be it. I might make a large one as well, depending, we'll see. But generally, there's not a lot of themes I can get away with in fantasy in terms of creativity. I'm just gonna be building these buildings in various different sizes and shapes, and then we're gonna stuff a certain shop inside. You know, it's going to be hard to differentiate them from one another, because essentially the only differences would be like a burger sign or something like that. We'll have to see when I get there, but I have some ideas planned, but I feel like the fantasy universe is going to be more about like making pretty, pretty buildings, bridges, gazebos, nice little things, and then just, you know, covering them up with some signs and, you know, putting a shop inside. So a lot of them could be really, what do you call it, like skins. So I could make like it's a shop, and then you put what shop you want inside. It's if it's burger or pizza, and then you put a few signs on it yourself. So I think that might be the route to go, but when I get there, I'll see. There might be some ideas that I have where the coffee shop might be this like quaint little cottage. You know, there are ideas that I have, and like the pip shop water, I could get some pretty cool ideas for fantasy. We'll see when I get there, but with these extreme sci-fi buildings, I can really do crazy stuff like giant flaming hot dogs and on giant grills, because it's all, you know, wires and mechanics doing this. And sci-fi for me gives me the most creativity in terms of creating themes. And here we got a donut shop, and, you know, we covered it with these big giant vats, sci-fi vats of icing and stuff like that. And we doing sci-fi panels, we did some sci-fi lighting on it. At the end of the day, it really comes out as its own, and I would have only been able to accomplish that with sci-fi. Like I said, you could strip out all the sci-fi and call it modern, and it works really well. I like sci-fi. I like the final touches of sci-fi, and it's going to be my thing from here on out, because I've already gotten 40 buildings like this, and I'm gonna keep just adding to it. And I don't think any of the other themes are gonna get as much love from me, but they're all, I'm gonna try and touch on them all. I'll always take a break from sci-fi and say, let's take a stab at fantasy. I've already done it. I made the Frosty train station. I made a pirate train station. And what else did I do? I did a festive gingerbread house. And they were all train stations. Everything that I tried outside of this theme. Yeah, so, I mean, I've tried it, and I will definitely do a little mini-series on it in the future. You know, a good dozen or so fantasy buildings. So, let's see how much time we have here. Been going for, this is quite a long episode, so hopefully you guys are making it through it. Looks like we're about 35 minutes in on a 45-minute video. So we got 10 minutes to go. And we're at our final stages. I was trying to see what it would look like if I popped the Missy Goods sign out. I kind of felt like there could have been an archway or something extra on the front, and I actually couldn't quite figure it out. I was talking to the guys about it, like, what could go here, and we just ended up leaving it. I couldn't quite find something that worked for me. So usually at this point of my building process, I'm trying to figure out what it is that I can add, and I'm thinking, you know, do we need any archways in the front? Do I need any tiny details? That red trim that I added to the door was kind of nice, and so I'm really just looking around trying to figure out what works and what doesn't work. I did end up finding a bug with it. I put the bathrooms against the wall, like against the glass wall on the inside, but there's a path that goes on the outside, so the inside and the outside paths will try to connect themselves. I wish there was a way you could make two paths right beside each other and have some sort of railing or way to force the guests or force the path not to connect with one another. Because the inside of this building, what I ended up doing is I moved the bathrooms to the back, but you have to have a space, like a one cube space on the inside, so that the guests can't walk through the wall. And so I figured it out in the end, and it works. I think there I was just taking screenshots. That's why you saw me fiddling around. I was trying to take some screenshots, show the group, and get some feedback. And now we're kicking back into finishing some touches on the sci-fi. So this is kind of like my signature touch. I do this to all my sci-fi buildings. I put like little kickers in on the bottoms of planters and different areas, and just try to get, they add a little bit of light to the buildings, and it looks good. And then we'll have to do some little mini sci-fi lights. And I really like the lighting system that I came up with. Now, the lighting that you guys have seen me use in Yetiland, I hadn't really played around with it too much when I was making buildings in the past. And it doesn't really usually work out on buildings because they're so bright. But if you turn the darkness down on it, it makes the light dimmer. So I played around with that here with the red lights you'll see in a second, after I place all these micro lights. And if you dim the red light all the way down, it becomes like a miniature version of it, and you can get some really nice effects. While I still feel like my older buildings don't need it, it could have worked nicely on some of them. Planet Gulpy has a little bit, but I feel like some green and blue, or whatever colors they use, a pink and blue, that could have worked. Going forward in my future buildings, I'm going to be using that tactic a little bit, and you'll see how nicely it works if you just use one of those colorable spotlights and dim it. Where are we? We should be getting to the end of it. Like, I should be doing my lighting pretty soon here. Now, sorry if the camera keeps stopping like that, because I stop and I talk to somebody or somebody's showing me something in Discord. I'll be sure in the next videos, like that, if I would have, it would have been really hard for me to find those areas and trim it all down because there was like 8 hours of recording here. So I just kind of speed it all up and then we just talk over it. So, there are little points in which where the camera stops, and in the future when I'm building one of these things, I'm probably just going to sit down, and if somebody messages me or if I have a problem or something that I need to figure out, I'm probably just going to stop the recording and figure it out and think about it off camera. And if someone needs help, I'll pause my recording and I'll help them out. I just did like one continuous recording, and you guys kind of caught all the little pause breaks in there, but at 10 times speed they're very minimal. But in the future I'll try to clean it up and get these episodes under half an hour. I think if we would have cut all those little spots out, we would have been at a half an hour. But it's all right. I had fun doing this, and it's good to just talk to you guys and hang out for a bit once again. So I'm going to give you guys, for those of you who have made it this far through the recording, I'm going to give you guys a heads up on what's next, and we're having some fun. So we haven't had a couple, like I didn't do an upload yesterday. I know some people said something about that. I don't even think I did one on Saturday. I needed a bit of a break, and that break just meant playing some Planet Coaster. So now I'm releasing the footage, and we haven't recorded any spotlights lately other than the guest appearance. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. Yeah, here I'm doing the red lighting now. You'll see it come together. So I haven't done any spotlights in a while. I haven't recorded any spotlights. I just needed a spotlight break because I've been just cranking on them, and it's been, you know, 400 hours a month of spotlights of me just working on it and editing them and recording them. Needed a bit of a break, and we need to get Yetiland done. So in the next episode, guys, we go back to the Yetiland War. We actually finally do it, and it's going to be the craziest episode. So after I'm done this, I'm crunching the footage as I'm recording this right now, and then, or compressing it, and then I'm going to put it in and speed it up, and I'm going to do a talk over just like I'm doing now, and I'll hopefully get that out to you guys tonight. And the Yetiland War, it's absolutely a crazy episode. Probably the craziest thing I've ever done. I was posting screenshots to people as I was going, and they were in voice chat, and they were like dying laughing. And every time they laughed, it made me do something even crazier. It's a little bit gruesome. I mean, gruesome in the sense of, if you believe snowmen are real, they're going to be losing some limbs, guys. So it's not that gruesome. None of the Yetis really get hurt, because I felt like they are mythical living creatures where the snowmen are literally just piles of snow and the gingerbread men are literally just cookies. So it doesn't really hurt to destroy them, because but killing Yetis and having blood and gore, that wouldn't work out too well. So we don't really have any Yetis that are really dying. There's a few. There's a couple hero snowmen that come out of the woodwork, but at the end of the episode, I'd have to say we get 1,000 people in the battlefield. It's absolutely insane. It really is. Hundreds of cookie warriors and hundreds of snowmen warriors. It's crazy. And we pose a few of, like, we made our battle line, and then we built our battle center. So there's like the two armies, and it's strength versus numbers. There's a ton of gingerbread men, a ton of snowmen, they got a ton of weaponry, and the Yetis, there's a good amount of them. There's like 30 or 40 of them. So if you think of, like, if you played Warhammer, you know, if you were like the Space Marines, you had a small army because they're so powerful. But if you were the Orcs, you had a large army. So their point value system is strength versus numbers. That's the sad pizza I was talking about right there. Oh, sad pizza. And I was looking, see, Chief of Beef. You can see the Chief of Beef. You got to see it there for a second. You can rewind it if you missed it. But yeah, it's a bug, I think. Unless they intended to do that. I don't know why they would call it Chief Beef Pizza. I don't know. And they screwed up the burger. I was showing that there. I guess that, yeah, this was me going on a tangent showing people stuff. So hopefully in the future, I'll try to clean that up a bit so we can shortened the length of the video. We're running at the end, and you guys are going to see the presentation in a second here, about a minute. So I have about a minute to wrap it up. So yes, you guys will see a Yetiland episode up next, and it's absolutely the craziest one. So be sure to come check that out. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'll hopefully try to get that out tonight. So in terms of spotlights, I'll get back to working on spotlights tomorrow, and I'll get some recordings done for that. We got some really hot spotlights. I think I have a list of 40 that I picked. We're gonna try and focus on coaster spotlights because we have this new voting system where you get to vote on the top 10 coasters if you're a Discord member or a patron. So become a patron, because there's a lot of fun events that we're doing, and we're gonna see a cool top 10 coasters of January coming up soon. I want to get a bunch of coaster spotlights done so we have a big variety to choose from for February. So here it is, everybody. This is the final presentation of Missy Goods. You get to see all of our work in its final glory. And you guys can download this on my workshop, put it in your scenes. I think it was a total of 1,400 objects. So quite compact. And that's pretty much going to do it for this episode, everybody. Thank you guys so much for watching. And let me know what you guys thought of this Let's Build down in the comments below. If you want to see more of them, if it was too long, I'll try and trim it down in the future. And if you guys want to watch me stream these things and watch me build these things, be sure to become a patron, because all my patrons get to participate in anything that I'm doing. And we're going to have more events in the future. We already have several events for the patrons and exclusive members. So they're really enjoying it. So all the benefits that you are listed as a patron, there's like more hidden benefits. So yeah, it's definitely worth it at the end of the day, I think. And we have a pretty thriving community in here. So come join us, be a part of it, and all that good stuff. Yeah, and that's pretty much it for this episode, guys. I just want to say thank you to all my patrons, and thank you for hanging out with me while building this. It was a lot of fun. And thank you to all my subscribers and viewers for hanging out, watching these Let's Builds and Let's Plays, because the spotlights are really what the show is about right now. And I would love to be able to do more creative stuff with you guys in the future. And I have some ideas for some mega builds that are going to require more than one person. So more info on that in the future, guys. And that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye now.